As a child, I had a natural attraction to nature, to animals, and to natural landscapes. I kind of settled down to a career and chose art as my profession. But that never quite satisfied. I wanted to return to those fantasies of my childhood. So I returned to school about age 40 to reinvent myself as a scientist. I was mixing iron powder with silica fume in an effort to influence how it was oxidizing. I mixed it together with the fine iron powder and got this incredible reaction right in front of me. It started to foam up and bubble and it got hot. I thought, well, that didn't work. And I threw the whole thing away. Next day came in and fortunately the garbage had not been cleared out. Looked in there and pulled out that chunk and tapped it on the counter and thought, well, geez, this is hard as cement. But it had nothing to do with silica fume and iron and water. I had been reading some printout from a manufacturer of silica fume. There was a warning, keep tightly closed because it will absorb CO2 right out of the air. And that was the epiphany and the opening of the pathway to Ferrock. Ferrock is a carbon negative material because it requires CO2 as a reactant. The iron from the steel dust reacts with CO2 to form iron carbonate. Around 2007, I stumbled upon the Tohono O'odham Community College in Arizona. And I bumped into a woman, Jane Latanay, at the college. And she said, we'd love to have green materials being developed out on the reservation. And the college would love to sponsor that. One fateful day, this guy walked up with a ponytail and said, hey, I heard you're doing something with glass. And that was Richard Pablo.
At first, I just took it as cleaning up the communities. People acknowledge that a lot of where they do their traditional harvesting, they grew up looking at that glass and they begin to be surprised that it was cleaned up. Everything that's in the Ferrock is of waste that America throws away. And if they could do something with that waste and make everything a whole lot better.
As the project director, it was important that I make this integrated with the local traditional culture. And I was more than happy to do that. That was the whole reason for coming out here. There was a time when the ancestors of the Tohono O'odham, the Hohokam, built these big, wonderful structures. So I felt there needs to be a revival of that type of architecture. As part of the culture, as climate change adaptation to keep things cooler on the inside, as a way of being greener, all those things. This little structure, simple and small though it is noteworthy for what it is not. It is not concrete. Now, there's no cement here, no binder other than the steel dust, which is a waste product. And that's combined with another waste product, the glass, and the third waste that's combined, which is CO2. I see Ferrock as an important new material to be developed. Really, the world is looking for new materials. There is only so much Portland cement that can be made. And it is extremely carbon positive. It puts out huge amounts of CO2. So they realize there has to be an alternative sooner or later. And Ferrock is one possible alternative.